Hello, NASDAQ followers, and welcome to another edition of Behind the Bell. I'm your host, Leanne Alfaro, and I sure do hope you like ginger because today's closing bell is all about it. I have the CEO of Reed's Inc. and a mug full here of Reed's All Natural Ginger Beer. We are drinking the Zero Sugar Original. I'm here with Val Stalivier, CEO of Reed's Inc. Thank you so much for joining us.
Hey, thanks for having me.
So start by telling us a little bit about Reed's Inc. and the kind of products you make.
Sure. So Reed's has been around for 30 years, but the last 2 years we've been focused on really revitalizing the company. So it really has been a transformation. The company had limited margins, and we're focused on a lot of different categories, and we did a whole turnaround plan on Reed's. We cut 100 SKUs, we focused on the core brands, we exited production, we hired a new sales team, new marketing team, and in February we raised capital to really tell our story. The company really hasn't really been out there in a position to be able to invest and tell the story of the number one ginger beer, why ginger beer is great for people, also the Virgil's brand, which is an all-natural soda. And so now we're really, 2019 is our breakout year. And part of that is moving to the NASDAQ and really taking the visibility of the company to the next level.
Absolutely. And you have the whole set of products to boot. So tell us a little bit about what we have right here on the table.
Sure. So these are two new products that we've launched. Reed's has always been in glass bottles. We have three different intensities of ginger, from 3,000 milligrams to 9,000 milligrams. We use fresh Peruvian organic ginger in our product, which really differentiates us from all of our competitors. And most recently, we've launched a zero sugar version of that, an all natural zero sugar version that tastes pretty close to the original recipe. And we've launched cans. We launched cans and zeros on Virgil's last year, and now that brand is growing double digits, and we expect the same positive impact on this innovation. Because certain channels really prefer cans over bottles, mm-hmm. So it really opens up the number of channels and different type of customers that we can actually start penetrating.
That's absolutely incredible. And this, what I have in my mug right now is the craft ginger beer with zero sugar.
This is the zero sugar.
It's so good.
Thanks.
And I loved that when you took the bottle out, you can actually see the ginger.
There's a little ginger in there, correct.
To the bottom of the bottle. That's amazing. Yeah. Now, you talked about how you're moving ahead with your marketing plans and
yes.
kind of revamping.
Yeah, we've never had the capital to go tell that story.
Now, I've read about your upcoming campaign for Mother's Day, and I think mm-hmm. it's positively clever. It's called They Fooled Your Mom campaign.
Correct.
So tell us a little bit more about that.
Yeah, so I think for generations, we've been given ginger ale as kids for upset stomachs. And there's really not enough ginger content in ginger ale to soothe any stomachs. We actually did a survey recently. 88% of moms today are giving their kids ginger ale or their family members ginger ale to soothe stomachs. And there was a recent settlement where, you know, Canada Dry, the number one ginger ale, is actually going to take off, made from real ginger, off their packaging. Mm. And so we thought it was the perfect time to go bust this myth once and for all. And if people want to give something that soothes stomachs, which is ginger is a superfood, has a lot of different health benefits, if they want to soothe stomachs, they should turn to Reed's, because we have a lot of ginger in our product, whereas ginger ale really doesn't. So we want to kind of bust this cycle of myths and moms giving their kids ginger ale.
And I love that approach, because especially when you're in a market when consumers are looking for honest products.
Yes, transparency.
For transparency, exactly.
Right.
It's great and very refreshing.
Yeah, and we want to make it
literally,
and we want to make it fun and for
right.
Mother's Day. And really, that's, you know, we're trying to keep it tongue in cheek and really get a dialogue going. You know, there's a lot of different communications to consumers today, and there's a lot that they have to process. And we're trying to break through and at least get a dialogue on, yes, ginger's great for you, and where they should go get it.
Mm-hmm. So you are definitely speaking to how you differentiate from your competitors, but
right.
could you talk to us a little bit more about other ways that Reed's really stands out from the rest?
Sure. So part of our new product innovation is really trying to be all things ginger. So we are piloting two very exciting new products. One is a ready-to-drink mule, because the number one ingredient in mules is ginger beer,
right.
and we're the number one ginger beer in the country, so it makes sense to have the ability to have a Moscow mule on the go.
Right.
So we're launching that in pilot. It'll be in four packs on the West Coast. We're also adding functionality to ginger. Ginger is a great functional ingredient. We're adding hemp to one of our lines, so it's a ginger wellness drink. And it has 15 milligrams of hemp extract, And so the combination of health benefits of ginger and hemp are combined because that's going to be a growing category. People are looking for natural functionality. That's another piece of news that's coming out this year. And eventually we're going to be launching a shot business, sort of a daily two-ounce shot of ginger.
Amazing.
We want to get Americans to have more natural ginger incorporated into their diets so they can have that health benefit. So all that is happening this year.
I love that. And I mean, ginger shots are the things you see every so often at
yes.
the coffee shop, but you don't really have access to on the regular.
Correct.
It seems that this will kind of improve access.
Absolutely.
People will be able to have access.
It's perfect for convenience stores and as well as the e-commerce section. It's hard shipping, you know, 24 cans of soda through the mail,
mm-hmm.
whereas the shots will enable us to actually have a very profitable package to start penetrating our presence on the web.
Amazing. Now, Val, could you talk to me a little bit about, I mean, Reed's having been in the industry for as long as it has, what are some of the changes that it's witnessed in the industry, and what does the future of this kind of production and what are consumers looking for?
Yeah, that's a great question. So there are macro trends that I believe Reed's really sits in the middle of. Moving to premiumization, moving to all natural ingredients, like you said, transparency. It's 2019. And Virgil's really is trying to disrupt the all natural soda category. You know, $80 billion in sales in soda, and we're still drinking things with artificial high fructose corn syrup, artificial flavors, colors, preservatives. So we believe there's a huge upside in moving people over. They've started moving away from mainstream beer to craft beer. That's a very big part of the beer category, but craft soda is still less than 1% of the category.
Mm-hmm.
So it really is our mission to go tell the story of it's 2019, it's time to really have your soda be all natural and make a smarter choice.
Absolutely, and we see this trend across all companies.
Correct, in food, in beverage,
exactly.
everywhere.
Exactly, we just had Beyond Meat here last
yes.
year, and they very much care about having that transparency, that relationship with the consumers. Now, today, as you ring the closing bell, we're also celebrating you coming on to the NASDAQ.
Yes,
so tell
we're
us
excited.
A bit,
yeah.
We're excited to have you.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about what that means for Reed's coming to
yeah,
NASDAQ.
Yeah, for us, it really is a milestone in the company. We really want to have this company break through and get to the next level. And so part of that is getting the message across. We can have a great message, but if no one's hearing it, then it's limiting our exposure on people coming in and actually being able to invest against our vision. And we believe NASDAQ is really going to help us get there. We were on an emerging exchange. Now we're on the big board with a lot of other visionary companies like Beyond Meat. And we just believe we're going to get a lot more exposure, a lot more liquidity. And so for us, if you have a great story, that's great. But broadcasting it is just as important. And I think NASDAQ's going to help us do that.
Well, we're really excited to broadcast it on our seven-story tower.
Super.
National television, just in a few minutes, right at 3:50 to 4 o'clock. Thank you so much for joining us, Val, and we'll see you downstairs.
Thank you.
NASDAQ followers, please stay tuned for more coverage right here from the NASDAQ market site and to watch Reed's ring the clock.